So we've definitely had a lot of playtime and a lot of time to readjust to the environment and all of the dogs and everything just generally going on at my house. But we've also started working on adjusting to our whole head harness. And what we're going to do is utilize this tool to allow us to have a nice, calm walk that doesn't result in us being dragged down the street kicking and screaming. But before we can get to walking, we have to acclimate to the tool itself. And so what we're doing for the past couple of days is luring the dogs to put their nose into the harness of their own volition. We're incorporating a lot of positive reinforcement because we do want to make positive associations between putting on this tool and getting to go for a walk or getting a reward. Something fun always happens after we put on our halter. We definitely take this acclimation process at the pace of the dog and one step at a time. First, we get used to putting our nose into the tool, and then we get used to having the weight of that tool resting on the top of our muzzle. Once we're comfortable having our muzzle in the tool for a few seconds at a time, I start to work on massaging the jaw, moving my hands closer to the ears in preparation to go ahead and get that halter fully secured before we start adding the leash and leash exercises. Lila did very well with these exercises and seemed to catch on pretty quickly. She didn't have much aversion to having things touching her face. I suspect that could be because she has the experience of being groomed and having her face handled in the past, but she does very well. Now that we've had the opportunity to get the head halter installed on her properly, everything situated where it should be, we're gonna go ahead and reward her for the longer periods of time that she can wear without messing with it. She's actually really good at this. I go ahead and ask her for a few basic obedience commands as well, and she's responding very positively. Lila's really adapting well, so I want to go ahead and take it to the next level where we guide her around with the head halter on. If we see her bring her paws up to paw or touch the harness, I just use my hands to put her paws back on the ground and remind her that I have a few treats in store for her, and we normally regain that focus. So here I'm just luring her around the chair in front of me, getting her used to moving and being guided with the head halter on. This is our first step to a walk on a leash, and she is going to do so well. I'm confident. We always want to start practicing with this tool in a low distraction environment, and low distraction can mean that there's not a lot of options of just other interesting things to do. There's not a lot of places to go, and I'm the most engaging thing in the room. You'll notice while we're practicing, I don't want to put any pressure on the head harness. I'm just getting her used to being guided and walking around with it. I am holding the clasp at the bottom, but it's loose and providing no pressure on her face.